So, hello and welcome to another episode of the Pascom Moby Dick School. Today's topic is setting up the telephones which we're going to use with our system. Now, what I have here today is I've got a bit of a test setup which we installed last week. You can see our server, our virtual server, which we installed last week. And I also have a SNOM telephone on my desk, which I'm going to add later on. Now, first things first, a few people have asked us why we start the setup process after the installation with or by setting up telephones. And the reason we do this is within the mobydick, the users and their extensions are completely separated from end devices and, say, for example, work locations, so home office and so on and so on. And the benefit of this is that, you know, users can log in anywhere, okay, without having to, you know, transfer settings for devices and so on. But the important thing is, to be able to do this, we have to set up the device first. And so for today's purposes, what we're going to do is we're going to install the SNOM telephone, and we're also going to install a softphone. Now, first things first, what we have to do to be able to install the SNOM telephone, because it requires a DHCP server, we need to go into the commander, and under the appliance menu, click on services. And when the services tab loads, we have to set up the DHCP server. Now, fortunately for us, mobydick is delivered with a DHCP server, so we can set that up just under this menu tab here. Okay, and as default, it's disabled, so we have to enable it. And we've got two options here. We can say yes, enable, or yes, only for phones. The yes for only for phones is a bit advanced. We'll talk about that later on in a future episode of the mobydick School. Now here, what we can see is that we have our, you know, ideal settings, which the mobydick automatically generates for us. Okay, so we can see that on Ethernet naught, we've got our IP address, and that is the base for what the mobydick will then say, okay, these are where the telephone's going to be on the network. Okay, so here we've got 100 telephones set up, so from 10 to 110. And we can also say here, for example, your domain name. So for example, if we were actually using our actual network, it would be telephone plus pascom.net or whatever. And then here, we have the DNS and gateway IP addresses. Now, it's quite sensible here and recommended, in fact, to use the IP address of mobydick. So for later on, should, for example, any critical DHCP or DNS requests need to be answered from the devices, the mobydick can always do this correctly and effectively. Okay, so these settings are all okay. What we could do here is then click on save. But before I do that, I just want to talk to you about, for example, if you're already in a network which has a DHCP server running and you don't want a separate network for a LAN network for your telephones, what you can do is, if you go into our wiki pages, you can see a setup using the Windows DHCP server, which gives you a really good description and detailed information of how you can do this. Which you can also then find out later in further information, not only in the wiki, but we will have further tutorials and webinars to this subject at a future date. So back to the commander. Here, we click on save. And in the meantime, I'm going to plug in my SNOM telephone. So there you go, you can hear a good click. Okay, and you can see here on the lights that it's all coming up, but nothing will happen just yet because I have to apply the DHCP server. Okay, so I've applied that and it will start booting by itself, and all the figures, all the information will be set up automatically. Okay, now we also have during this process a few bits and pieces that will be done, and I've got a presentation as to tell you what's happening. Okay, so if I just go onto my PowerPoint here. Okay, so in a process that is known as auto-provisioning or auto-configuration, what happens is as soon as the DHCP server is set up and the phone is connected to the network, it will then start sending a DHCP request to the mobydick, and it will be requesting its IP address. Now, of course, the mobydick will then reply with an IP address, but it'll also tell the phone that it's got centrally stored configurations for the phone. And the phone thinks, wow, I can set up myself automatically here, which means for you as an admin or a user that you don't have to do anything yourself. It runs automatically, okay? And this will then be retrieved from the mobydick server centrally. And the settings will then be installed on the phone. So, for example, all sorts of further information, such as not only the IP address, but also if there's any user information attached, whatever, that can be set up at this point in time as well. In our scenario, it won't happen because there are no users set up yet. Okay, so now if we have a look at the telephone, you can see here that it's automatically recognized by the mobydick. Because it's got the emergency only, it's got the date and time, and it also says down here, not registered. Now, what that means is there's no user registered at the moment. The emergency only is a really good, cool feature of IP phones, is when they're connected to the network, but they don't have a user logged in. Say, for example, there's some sort of emergency, there's a fire or somebody's picked up an injury, you can grab the nearest phone and be sure that through the emergency only mode, you can get hold of the emergency services if you so need that, okay? Now, if we go back into the commander, this will then show you how it appears in the device list. So under devices, we click on device list and the phone will automatically be there. And we can see it here. At the moment, it's yellow because there's no user assigned. So in the next episode, when we start adding users, you'll see how this appears once it's ready to telephone and so on and so on. Okay, so that's it for the SNOM. The next important thing is to talk about softphone. And I mean, in this particular setup, it's a trial version, and for you guys who are probably trying the community version before you go onto a more productive system, it's probably quite a good idea to use soft phones because they're cost effective, or in fact, in many cases, even free. You can test the system as much as you possibly can, get used to how to use the system, and you don't need any extra hardware like these SNOM phones or so on and so on and so on. Okay, now if I want to add a soft phone, we have a few recommendations. In this particular test, we're going to use X-Lite, which we can see here. This is a free download that it runs on all major operating systems. So, you know, you can use it on Windows, Mac OS X, you can use it on Linux, and then you can set up your soft phones that way. Okay, now what we could do is if we go back to the commander quickly, under add, we can now set up our soft phone. Now, the first item on the create device list for the English version is set up any manufacturer or soft phone. So yeah, of course, we're setting up a soft phone, we click on that. Okay, now here, we want to give the soft phone a username. Now this is important, we don't want to give the username of the intended physical user. So for example, you or I, we need to give it a username that's unique to the actual soft phone. Okay, so here what we could do is we can add, just call it soft phone one. And then we also need to assign it a password, which they can then log into the mobydick with. Test that up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, and that's all we really need to do at this point for on the mobydick side. Click save. And once that's gone through, we then need to click on apply. And it's always important that we click apply. Okay, and you can see from this box here, it's applying the telephony configurations, and shortly it'll be available and we'll be able to log in from our soft phone that we've got here. Now, to set up a soft phone, using X-Lite in this scenario, but I mean, you don't have to use X-Lite. For example, if you're using Mac, you can go to the Android store and download Telephone, which is another soft phone. But for features, I would recommend using, say, for example, X-Lite, much more effective. Okay, here we've got account name. You can change that if you want to, but we don't really need to. But perhaps in larger business environments, it may be sensible to do so. But for our purposes, it doesn't matter. And now we need to set up the software, the user ID that we set up within the mobydick, and we call it softphone1. Now we need to enter the domain name or domain IP address for the mobydick so it can actually try log on to the network, which is there. And we need to set, enter the password, which we used earlier. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Done. Now here, display name, this is one piece of information you could perhaps do, is you could then here set up the display name of your intended user for later on. So I'm going to call mine James Barton, okay? And then we need to also put in an authorization name, which it can then communicate to the mobydick. And for these purposes, we're going to use softphone 1. Okay. Here, under domain proxy settings, everything here is as default set up correctly, so we don't need to do any further editing of settings here. So we just press OK. And we can see straight away that the status of the phone is already green, so that's already up and running. Okay. But of course, because there's no user assigned, can't make any phone calls just yet. Okay. So here, we can see both phones are available within the device list, and in the next episode I'll show you how to log in or add users and then get ready with actually making some telephone calls. Thank you for watching. If you want any more information, please refer to the mobydick school website, where you'll find further information and documentation, for example our wiki pages. Until next time, goodbye.